In this video, we will solve this problem. Let's determine VC of T, voltage across the capacitor. So in this circuit, we have a dependent source. It is a current controlled voltage source. Which current is controlling here? I. The I is the current flowing through 2 ohm resistor. That is controlling this voltage source. Okay, it's a current controlled voltage source. Okay. And we have a switch, it opens at t equal to 0. So, first one we will see for t less than 0, what is the equivalent circuit here. Okay, t less than 0, that switch is closed that time, this switch is closed. So, 10 volt and you have a closed switch here because it opens when t equal to 0. So before that it is closed. Then you have a resistor 2 ohm and current controlled voltage source, and you have a RLC network here. 9.2 mF current through this IL and voltage is VC. Okay, this is 10 volt. Okay, so for t greater than 0, t greater than 0, switch is opened. So this 10 volt nowhere come into picture. So we have here 2 and 3i. 9, so this is IL and VC 2 mF and current passing through is I. Okay, this is t greater than 0. Now step 1, we have to calculate alpha, that is R by 2L. In that we need R here. Since this circuit has a dependent source, first we have to calculate what is the equivalent resistance seen by capacitor and inductor. Okay, and it is, we can clearly see that it is a series RLC, but we have to find the equivalent resistance we have to find. So for that, so equivalent resistance is this resistance here, it is seen by this L and C. Okay. So for that, what you have to do, you have to, that is, you have to find a R equivalent for t greater than 0, not t before 0, that t greater than 0, that time what is the equivalent resistance. So that you have to see. So what is the equivalent resistance? For that you have to find like this, you, this one and this one here. Here you have capacitance and inductance. This is the R equivalent. You have to find R equivalent. This is 3i and you have 2 and this is I. So this value is 9. Okay. So now R equivalent, how to find, what is the method? In this same method, how you calculate input and output impedance in analog electronic circuit, same method you have to follow here. So first remove the load here. Here load is capacitance, inductance, remove that and apply a test source, maybe voltage or current, and then find the ratio. So then find the ratio. So I will apply a voltage source Vx which gives current of Ix. Okay, now you apply KVL here. If you apply KVL, this will be Vx, that Vx is equal to Ix into what is the first one, 9 Ix, then minus 3i, this I is same as Ix, you can see here, this Ix current is flowing through this. See, I is same as Ix here. So this I is Ix. So 9 minus 3 Ix and plus 2 Ix. So if you solve this, Vx is 8 Ix you will get here. This is Ix into 9, okay, Ix into 9, this one. So you will get 8 Ix. So R equivalent is ratio of Vx by Ix. That is nothing but 8 ohm. So you will get 8 ohm R equivalent, okay. So once you know the R equivalent, calculating this will be easy. So alpha equal to R equivalent by 2L. So if you substitute and calculate, you will get 0.8, 0.8 per second you will get. And omega naught is 1 by root LC if you calculate. So you will get the value of, I think it is 10 radian per second. Okay. So next one, once we know this one, we can compare alpha and omega naught. Omega naught is greater than alpha, so response will be underdamped. Response will be underdamped. And underdamped response, we have to calculate one more parameter, that is omega d, that is omega naught square minus alpha square. Okay, so if you calculate this one, we'll get 9.96 radian per second. Okay, that is the step one. So step one, what we did, we found R equivalent. Since the circuit has a dependent source, we have to find the equivalent resistance seen by the inductor and capacitor. Okay, so remove the inductor and capacitor, apply a test source, find the ratio of Vx by Ix, you will get R equivalent. Okay, then step two. So step two, you have to find now initial value of current and voltage. So we have to see that first this circuit, just see here, t less than 0, this is the circuit. In this, you have to find first Vc of 0 minus and IL of 0 minus. I think here at t equal to 0 minus, capacitor act like an open circuit, this act like a short circuit. So in this loop, capacitor is in series. So if it is open circuit, this complete loop will be open. This loop is open means none of the current flows through this loop. This loop, none of the current flows. So what is the IL of 0 minus? IL of 0 minus will be 0 since it is open. However, a current flows through 2 ohm resistor because of the 10 volt battery. There will be a current. But no current flows through these components because this capacitor is open. Okay, so IL of 0 minus. IL of 0 minus is 0 ampere. Now you have to find Vc of 0 minus. So Vc of 0 minus is this one. So if you copy paste here that circuit, okay. So in this we have to find Vc of 0 minus. So Vc of 0 minus that is at t equal to 0 minus, what is the voltage across this capacitor? And remember, during that time at t equal to 0 minus, no current flows through this part of the circuit. Okay, and we are asking what is the voltage across this capacitor. Okay, no current flows through this part of the circuit. So eventually Vc of 0 minus, whatever you are this will act like a short, inductance act like a short at DC, under DC condition. So Vc of 0 minus is nothing but you are asking voltage at this one. This is Vc of 0 minus. No current flows through 9 ohm. And this is voltage across capacitor. And this act like a short. It is nothing but Vc. So you have to calculate voltage across these two nodes you have to calculate. And in this one, you have two components. One dependent source, another one is the resistor. So this resistor carries current because of this 10 volt battery. What is that I? So I is 10 by 2, that is 5. So I we have calculated 5. Now remaining is 3, the voltage VC of 0 minus is voltage across this plus voltage across this. Okay, so that one we have to calculate. So we will using KVL, if you calculate, so VC of 0 minus, so VC of 0 minus is nothing but if you apply the KVL like this, so minus sign is here, plus sign is here, but we are calculating like this, so it will be minus 3i plus voltage across 2 ohm resistor is 10, so that is 10. And I we just now calculated, it is minus 3 into 5 plus 10. So minus 15 plus 10 is minus 5 volt. Minus 5 volt you will get. Okay. So that is VC of 0 minus. So VC of 0 plus is nothing but VC of 0 minus, that is equal to minus 5 volt. Okay. So that is about the initial condition. We know IL of 0 minus, that is equal to IL of 0 plus equal to 0 ampere. Okay, that is a step 2. Step 3, you have to find the response now. Since it is underdamped circuit, so VC of t is equal to e power minus alpha t into B1 cos omega dt plus B2 sin omega dt. Sin omega dt. Okay, so in this we know VC of 0 plus, so VC of 0 plus is minus 5 volt, that we know. That if you substitute here and t equal to 0, if you substitute, this will be B1, so B1 equal to minus 5. That is the step 3. And step 4, you have to calculate one more constant, that is B2. For that, one more equation we need, that we can easily get by differentiating VC of t with respect to t and equating t equal to 0 plus. So if you differentiate and substitute t equal to 0, what you get is B2 omega d minus B1 alpha. Okay. So this is differentiate with respect to time and equate t equal to 0, you will get this. Okay, so after that, but this one, this side, this is equal to IC of 0 plus divided by C. DVC by DT, T equal to 0 is nothing but IC of 0 plus by C. That you should equate it to this equation, okay, B1 alpha. So we need now IC of 0 plus. We need IC of 0 plus, we need. So you can see in this circuit at t greater than 0, that is in this circuit, at t equal to 0 minus, IL of 0 minus is 0. We had calculated that. So IL of 0 plus also will be 0 because inductor resists abrupt change. Because of that, since capacitor is in series with inductor, IC of 0 plus also will be 0. There will be no current passing through the capacitor at time instant t equal to 0 plus. So IC of 0 plus is 0. This is easy here in this. So this will be 0. This will be 0. So what is the remaining now? B2 omega d minus B1 alpha equal to 0. So you substitute value here, B2 and this one. So if you substitute value, omega d is 9.968 and B2 minus B1, B1 is minus 5, so it will be plus 5 into alpha, that is 0.8 equal to 0. So if you substitute, you will get value B2 equal to minus 0.4013 volt. Okay, so total VC of t, so VC of t will be e power minus alpha t, that is this one, and B1 value is minus 5 cos omega d is 9.968 t, and minus 0.4013 sine 9.960. Okay, this is the solution.